Hi guys, how you doing? Welcome back to Peaks 47. I'm going to start off with some news just quickly before we move on to the video. The main part of this video is the water pour, the resin pour that I've recently done over my shoulder there where the viaduct is. We'll move on to that in a minute. I've just got a couple of things I wanted to put past you. So the WWS group on Facebook, the helps, discussions and tips, I'm an admin on there along with Martin, the owner, and Craig Shaw from Northern Rails 44. We're looking at growing the group, so I'm going to leave a link in the description. So if you want to join the group and you're on Facebook, please come and give us a join. There's loads of information on there, but on scenery, dioramas, model railway stuff, military dioramas. It's generally just a catch up and a bit of a laugh and loads of tips on getting the best out of your static grass, regardless of brand. Obviously, the main stuff on the group is WWS, it's a WWS group. But if you've got amazing scenery and any work that you've got, it doesn't have to be WWS, please share it on there. We're just really enthusiastic about scenery in general, so we get lots of bits and bobs on there. Loads of people are giving tips out. People are learning a lot. I'm learning a lot. Everyone's learning. Loads of people are giving tips at the same time as well. So it's a really great group. So come and join and see what you think. We've got competitions that we run sort of regularly as well. Also, I've got Chris Nevard coming here next Wednesday to put Peaks 47 in Model Railway Mag as in a future feature. Really excited about meeting Chris and really excited about seeing what sort of pictures he takes. There's a lot of new stuff now on this layout that wasn't in the Hornby magazine feature. So that'll be interesting to see, like the crash corner in there, the water pours obviously in there now, the farmer's cottage up in the corner, that's all new as well. There's extra details that I'm sort of frantically rushing and doing before he gets here. Also, the Hornby magazine, I've got their awards again this year. I've been fortunate enough to be nominated in that category against some really top layouts. I don't expect to win. I'm just honoured to be in that lineup. But if you did want to vote for me, please go ahead. Also, in specialist retailer, WWS are in it for the first time. They've got my vote. Obviously, if you want to vote those, that would be great as well. And then, yeah, basically, this video is now going to be doing the resin. So hopefully, you might pick some tips up on that. It's a bit of a step-by-step, although I'm not very experienced in it. It's more of just of a step-by-step how I did it, more than a step-by-step guide. Really pleased with the product. It went off quick. There wasn't any air bubbles in it. It hasn't turned yellow. There's no solvent pop in it. It was a really, really easy to use, considering I'm not experienced with it. It just went down and worked out exactly how I wanted it to. Hopefully you enjoy the video. You might not see me for a while. I'll hopefully get another video in another couple of weeks. But for those of you that don't know, I'm now working for myself as a car polisher and detailer. I've used the 14 years experience that I've gained as a paint sprayer in the motor trade, and now I'm working for myself. I'm going to leave a link in the description. I'm trying to build my social media. I've got a page now. I'll leave the link to the page. If you could give me a like on my works page, I'd really appreciate that, guys. Anyway, all the best. That's enough of me waffling on. Let's go and have a look at some decent modelling. Cheers, guys. So here's the stuff that I'm going to be using. It's a new product from Whirlwind Scenics. As you can see, it's a 2-to-1 ratio. I'm going to use a stick for this, so I'm doing it via volume rather than weight. It is recommended you do it by weight. I don't have any scales, so I'm going to do a test and see if it goes off. The maximum you can do is 10 mil pours at a time. Recommended that you prime it first, so anything between 2 mil and 5 mil, I think it says on the back. So I'm going to brush a coat on first, but for the purpose of the test, I'm going to mix up a little bit, 2-to-1, in this plastic cup. I'm going to have a go at tinting it ever so slightly with some acrylic paints. Perhaps something like this. Flat brown and a little bit of this flat green, or even some raw umber. So I'm going to mix a tiny little bit up with a tiny drip in it. We'll go over now and have a look where the pour is going, and you'll see why I just maybe want to put a hint of colour into it. I might even just leave it clear. I'll have a play, show you the results, and then hopefully we can move on to doing the pour. So here's where the pour is going. All these real rocks are from down the estuary. These are all glued in place. We've got a brown board at the bottom. Got some weeds and bits of weathering and stuff in there. Goes under these two viaducts at the back. So I'm going to weather the inside these a bit with a bit of green moss and concrete dust. And what I've done at the back, which is out of shot, as you can see, I've just created a dam along here. And the idea of that is just to basically keep the resin in place so it can't disappear. I can detail all around here at a later date. For now, I just need it to look good from this sort of angle. I'm actually going to use this beaker. This beaker takes into account of the cup doing a V, so the ratios are going to be a bit more correct. If I was using a stick, it would need to be technically a straight up type of cup. So I've got the measurements here on the side. This one's 2:1. So I'm going to end up mixing up about 80 mil in total here. So I'm going to put the resin in. And then adding the hardener. That is now activated and just needs a stir. So what I may do is use this resin as my primer layer rather than wasting it. I'm going to go easy with tinting it, see what we can do with it. Right, so I'm going to start with a little bit of this one, this flat brown. I'm just going to put one drop in and see if that's too little or too much. As you can see, one tiny drop has really made that go murky. So I certainly won't be putting any more than that in. I can use this now as my priming layer. I'm going to do the same with the green. So you can see how quickly that can change with such a small amount. Fortunately, this will still be okay as a priming layer, because as it looks so green in the pot, as you see on my finger there, or even on a piece of card, it's not actually that green. So that's the primer layer down. I've got to leave that 20 hours now. So I'll come back to this tomorrow night after work. In the meantime, I'm just going to do some little bit of weathering around here.
and a little bit up here. Perhaps in the morning, once it's starting to go tacky, just want to add some sort of damp streaks inside these areas. And then hopefully can be ready for the pour. Right, so it's been 24 hours. As you can see, I've got some MDF here with some parcel tape on. I'm going to flip that round, glue that and create a dam with it. The idea of the parcel tape is the resin shouldn't stick to that. So then when I pull it away, this should pull away quite freely. I'm going to put a bead of silicone along it as well, just to double check to create a seal. I'll show you that now. And then hopefully I can get on with the pour. So here's the edge that I've got to block. So the parcel tape will sit along there. As you can see, there's still a little bit of a gap and I'm not sure if I'm going to rely on just screws to pull that in. So I'm going to put a bead of silicone along here, screw that in, and then I'll be ready to go. So that's all screwed into place now. As you can see, I've wiped away the excess silicone. So I'm hoping now, once I leave that half hour or so, and that's gone off, I can start my pour and hopefully won't have any leaks. So the silicone's gone off now. I'm going to start with half a litre, see how I get on with that. As a maximum of a 10ml pour, I might need more than half a litre for this first pour. While I'm talking about the layer thickness for the primer, that can focus. It's actually 0.2, it's 0.5 mil, so a brush coat I would say is enough. 200 microns to 500 microns, which is what obviously I've already done. As far as tinting it goes, I'm going to put even less of these in, almost nothing. I'm tempted to actually not put any in at all. I'm going to get it mixed up first, half a litre, using the 2-to-1 on the side of the cup again. And I can come up to here, which is going to actually give me about 450 mil. Right, so that's the first pour in. I had to mix up another 300 mil just to get this front end. The dam seems to be working quite successfully at the minute. And I'm actually quite happy with that depth as it is, and I'm not sure if I will do another pour on that. Obviously, once this dries now with basing glue, I'm going to start putting some ripples in it and try and dry brush some white areas, try and replicate some current coming either side of the viaduct. But all in all, I'm quite pleased with that so far. So it's been a little bit more than 24 hours because of work commitments. So it is dry now. It's still nice and clear. There's no solvent popping it, no air bubbles. It hasn't turned yellow. Really impressed with the stuff. I don't think I'm going to give it another pour. I'm happy with that depth. I've got some rocks that are still exposing, which are what I wanted. Now I'm going to try and use some basing glue and just try and add a little bit of current in places. I'm not going to put ripples all over it with Mod Podge or basing glue or anything like that, because I want to keep that gloss level, because I'm really happy with the gloss. But I am going to put some detail sort of around these sort of edges perhaps. So I'm going to get the dam off now and see what it looks like down here, see if it will actually unstick. So this might be something I have to do in stages. I've got some basing glue in a cup, and I'm going to put some sort of like ripples and streaks sort of here where the water's been forced down either side. Same with this one. The idea is that that's going to lose that smoothness that the resin's got, and then when I dry brush it with white, it should pick up and create a little bit of white water where these rocks are just sticking out here, which is what I want to sort of aim for, a little bit round here as well perhaps. The basing glue's dry now. You can just see the ripples here. I'm just going to try and dry brush this area now, especially around sort of the rocks, and try and create some streaks. I don't want to overdo it. This is acrylics I'm using, so I can sort of wipe it away and sort of reattempt if I need to. I just think I'll probably need to wipe it as I go, just to tone it down a little bit. But it's trying to pick up the channels of water a little bit. You can just see here in the shot here where this rock is actually proud. So I think there'll be some white water coming around this one and fading off again as it settles.